The thing I noticed in every house was the book. The book was there. I said to the mother, why do you fast in Ramadan? Why? What is the point? And she said to me, I fast in Ramadan to remember the poor. Allahu Akbar. This woman who knew only tribulations was emptying her stomach to thank God. For an empty stomach, what is this? And I thought at that moment, Sheikh, if this is Islam, I want to be Muslim.
Allahumma thabbithum ala al-iman warzuqhum a'la al-jinan kama razaqtahum hidayat al-Qur'an. Bil-Qur'an, ihtadayt.
Bil-Qur'an, ihtadayt fi rahbihi tahlu al-hayat shawqan ila al-mawla atay aslamt ruhi lil-ilah nur al-hanaya wa al-tuluh lillahi a'lantu al-rujuh ayatuhu taghdu shumu' wa yafidu fi qalbi sana
nur al-hanaya wa al-tuluh
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Lorne Booth. I am a British journalist, broadcaster, and human rights activist. I am blessed with two daughters called Holly and Alexandra. I was married before, that's why I have two children who are now 11 and 13. I divorced from their father before Islam, and alhamdulillah, I've now remarried to a Muslim man.
وهي تحب أن نناديها بعد إسلامها باسم سارة. وسيكون خطابي لك دائما في هذا اللقاء باسم سارة بإذن الله عز وجل.
عاشت سارة طفولتها مع والدين غير ملتزمين بتعاليم المسيحية، وكان والدها مدمنا للخمر وأمها عارضة للأزياء، ولكنها منذ الصغر كانت تشعر بوجود إله لهذا الكون.
From the age of five, very very small, I loved to pray. I love to speak to God. I knew in my heart there was one God. Not three gods, not two in one, not all of these one. But as you grow up in the West, how do you keep that connection in your heart?
بدأت قصة أختنا سارة مع القرآن في فلسطين حين زارتها زيارة صحفية. فوجدت القرآن موجود في كل بيت.
So there I met people living in poverty who were living under occupation. There I met mothers whose children were crippled, dead or in prison. But there I did not meet hopelessness. I met people of hope and people of warmth and people who had more joy in them than I did. And the thing I noticed in every house was the book. The book was there. Okay. And the Quran was always on a special place. Or they'd say, look, our book tells us how to behave. So I came to feel that this book was a guidebook to being good. And I knew that I was not a good person at that point. I thought this book, the Quran, must be a guidebook to helping others.
ذهبت سارة للتسوق قبل رجوعها إلى بريطانيا، ومن ضمن قائمة التسوق وضعت القرآن للفضول والاطلاع. اشترته عند رجوعها إلى بيتها فتحت المصحف.
Remember that in 2006 I was drinking, smoking, very selfish, hedonistic. And I opened it with, yeah, let's have a look. Arrogance. Not peace, I came to arrogance. And I read this. And it's Surah Hud, yeah. Ayah 102. Surah Hud, 102. Thus much is the punishment of God your Creator when He overtakes the towns whose inhabitants have proved themselves to be wrong-headed and wrongful of actions and grow daily more and more wicked. The divine act of overthrowing the wicked is indeed painful and terrifying. Whoa, I was scared.
وكذلك أخذ ربك إذا أخذ القرى وهي ظالمة إن أخذه أليم شديد.
يا نفحة القرآن فوحي عطرًا على قلبي وروحي يا بلسمًا يطوي جروحي لولا الهداية ما
هذا قدر الله سبحانه وتعالى لها بأنه تم تخويفها في هذا الوقت لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى يعلم بأنه خيرا لها فالقرآن الكريم يحتوي على الترغيب ويحتوي على الترهيب فالله سبحانه وتعالى أعلم بما هو خير للبشر.
Every page just seemed to tell me that I was a sinner and I was going to hell and God was angry with me. So when I started traveling the Middle East as a non-Muslim and as a reporter and journalist, I began to be moved by the clear expressions of manners. I was in Ramallah on my first ever visit to the West Bank and I didn't have a coat because, long story, and I was cold. And an old lady came and she said, yalla, yalla, imshi, imshi. She pulled me into her house. I didn't think this actually happened. I didn't in the 21st century, I can't believe it. So that's the kind of generosity that we can give to one another and should when we're practicing the teachings of the Holy Quran.
في 2008 كانت لها زيارة أخرى إلى فلسطين وكانت لهذه الزيارة أثر كبير على أختنا سارة لأنها كانت في رمضان وفي هذه الزيارة زارت إحدى العوائل الفلسطينية هناك.
And I knocked on the door. And the mother opened the door like this. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Fadal. She was so full of light. She was full of light. Her eyes were shining. Her skin was shining. And she opened the door as if I was going into the Taj Mahal, as if she lived in the most beautiful place in the world. And when I went into her home, what was in her home, Sheikh? Fish. Nothing. Nothing. A room like this, but empty. Only walls, floor, ceiling. And one rug, and the iftar for 10 people was on the rug. And what was the iftar? One plastic plate of hummus. One plastic plate of khubz. One plastic place, salad. So when I sat down, I said, no. Wallahi, I tried not to eat. Sheikh, I tried not to eat that woman's food, but she kept giving me food. She said, you are our guest. And she gave me so much, and she wouldn't take no, and I ate, and I felt angry. I felt angry at Islam. I felt angry at a book that would tell hungry people to be hungry for 30 days. I was angry at the Quran for telling this poor woman not to drink water when always her water is dirty. So I said to the mother, why do you fast in Ramadan? Why? What is the point? And she said to me, I fast in Ramadan to remember the poor. Allahu Akbar. This mother who had nothing in dunya, nothing, will never have perhaps anything in life. She was humbling her heart for other people who had less. What is this? This this woman who knew only tribulations was emptying her stomach to thank God. For an empty stomach, what is this? And I thought at that moment, Sheikh, if this is Islam, I want to be Muslim.
فعزمت للرحمن أمري وعلى خطاها مشي قرب القرآن برحبه تحلو الحياة شوقا إلى المولى أتاي أسلمت روحي للإله قرب القرآن
استمر أثر هذا الموقف في قلبها، لكنها لم تقبل على الإسلام إلى الآن. وفي يوم من أيام رمضان دخلت مسجدا في لندن مع صديقتها للاطلاع على أجواء المسلمين في رمضان، وكان هذا في عام 2010.
Then I went into the masjid, and you know, in Ramadan it's not quiet. I sat down to watch. But when I sat down, I felt like I was under a waterfall of peace. And I was scared because I knew that this peace meant that Islam was the truth. And then 1 week later in London, I went into another masjid and I took shahada.
ونطقت بالشهادة في مسجد كبير بلندن. وقابلت هناك الإمام والمؤذن.
And they sat me down and spoke to me and explained about Al-Fatiha, that you, this is the key, the opening to your prayer. This is what it means. And all the time they were speaking, it was as if the room was heavy, you know? Yeah, a feeling in the room of maybe peace. And you say the words and they're very big words to say. I testify that there is no God but God. You expect there to be a thunderclap. You know, really, they're very heavy words. Just recognizing the enormity of knowing why you're born, why you exist, what you should be doing every day.
أجمل ما في قصة سارة لما أخبرت ابنتيها بأنها دخلت الإسلام.
And at the time they were 10 years old and 8 years old. And I said to them, your mum is thinking of becoming a Muslim, what do you think? And they said, we have 3 questions. And the first question was, when you are a Muslim, will you still be our mummy? And I said, yeah, I think I'll be a better mother. The second question was, when you are a Muslim, will you still drink alcohol? I said, I'll never drink alcohol again. They said, if you are a Muslim, will you still wear revealing clothing? I said, why did you ask me this? And my daughter Holly said, because you always show your neck and chest area and we hate it, we want you to stop. I said, look, if I'm Muslim, I will always be modest when I leave the house. And they said, we love Islam, that's it. And alhamdulillah, my daughters became Muslim and began praying with me straight away. Subhanallah.
بعد الإسلام رجعت وفتحت المصحف بمرات وكرات كثيرة وعديدة. ماذا وجدت المصحف بعد الإسلام؟
It was a completely different book. It was a different book, but the voice of strength was the same. I could see them, hear the might of God in there. I could hear the sternness and the risk of retribution, but now came the beauty. Now came the chance of Jannah. I just had to change. Allahu Akbar.
أنت ما شاء الله من عائلة رئيس الوزراء البريطاني السابق توني بلير كان متزوج أختك وهذا له مكانة اجتماعية كبيرة على أختك وعلى 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 العائلة، هل كان له أثر عليك سلبا أم إيجابيا عند دخولك الإسلام؟
Unfortunately, my brother-in-law Tony Blair has been involved with some of the most heinous criminal acts against human beings of the last century. We think of Iraq and Afghanistan. These are crimes against humanity, and the people who profit from them, whose businesses make money now out of Iraq, are in my family. How was I supposed to react? How was I supposed to react? I'd already shunned Tony Blair. I said, khalas, no, this is no good. On a political and human grounds, this is no good. But then I said my shahada, and everybody said, you know, Allah tells us don't break relations, be kind. And when I read the ayah that said very clearly, no, if your family go beyond justice, that's the line. And if you are being unjust, you have to look at yourself as well. And I felt relief, and I thought, right, I do not have to accept injustice while it's being done for whoever does it, however powerful they are and however close.
سبحان الله هذه الآية اللي ذكرتيها سبحان الله في حياتك، مهما كانت شخصية الإنسان ومهما كانت مكانة الإنسان، الله سبحانه وتعالى ذكرها في سورة النساء، يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا قوامين بالقسط شهداء لله ولو على أنفسكم أو الوالدين والأقربين. أصبحت قراءة سارة للقرآن مختلفة مع أنها لا تجيد قراءة اللغة العربية، ولكن رسائل القرآن تصل مباشرة إلى القلوب.
If I leave the Quran for 2 days, there is a sharpness to life. It's like kind of walking on glass. Like things will get to you, things will stab at you in a small way, but you know you'll be affected. I will be affected by things directly.
الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول الذين يأكلون الربا لا يقومون إلا كما يقوم الذي يتخبطه الشيطان من المس.
So Sheikh, it's an odd choice to choose a fairly unspiritual, very practical verse in the Quran. I know, you know, most people were drawn towards, I want to read about what Jannah is about, or I want to be afraid of hellfire. But when I first read this, it's incredible, because it was in 2010 when we were talking about the world banks crashing, when it looked like American finance was finished. Today, all of the world is touched by riba. Kuwait is touched by riba. No. Muslims are touched by riba. Everything that we buy, somebody, the shopkeeper is selling it you with riba. Allahu Akbar, how do we cleanse ourselves? Riba is devouring the business world. It's devouring humanity. It's making us slaves. We are slaves because of riba. We are abid riba.
ثبتني يا الله على طريق الهدى فكل ما أخشى سوء الختام غدا.
You're probably wondering about people like me who've come to Islam, and I'm telling you, 3 years ago I was not in hijab. 3 years ago I was not going to be Muslim. Let me ask you this: would you buy a car of someone who hated cars and preferred bicycles? Or would you go to an expert in cars? Don't seek out messages from people who've already decided they hate Islam. Go to a masjid, speak to an imam, go to the Quran yourself, and most of all, ask God for guidance to the truth. That's all, and may the truth find you.
أختنا سارة، شكرا لك من القلب. أنا وفريق العمل أريد أن أعرف أمنية أختنا سارة.
I have a very small charity called Peace Trail in the UK, and we are determined to work in the area because it says in the Quran, no. Take care of the people around you first. No. You know, my heart is in Gaza, but my life is here. Allah has put us here to make a difference. No. So we've been looking for a while at buying a house to look after between 6 and 10 sisters and their families, because these revert to Islam. There's many now. 5,000 Muslims coming to Islam every year, and the sisters, wallahi, they're struggling. Sometimes they are abused by their new Muslim husbands, may Allah forgive us all. Sometimes their family kicks them out and they have nowhere to live. And the new community, Sheikh, we're not looking after them properly. And it breaks your heart when the new sisters, they go to the church and the church looks after them. So I ask Allah, Allah provides everything.
بعد أن علمت بأن موقع نون سيساهم معها في مشروعها الدعوي فرحت سارة فرحا لا يوصف.
Sheikh, are you serious? Are you serious?
نعم بإذن الله عز وجل.
Do you know how much this means? That there are sisters who are leaving Islam right now, and some of them have gone into prostitution and gone into drugs because we have not had this happen. And we know families right now who can move into this house. And, you know, before we finish this interview, I asked Allah, before you told me this, I said, Allah, please provide for these sisters. And you've just said this, and I can't believe it. Yes, I can. I'm amazed. Wallahi, literally, when I made dua upstairs, I was asking for help for this. And subhanAllah, this is great news to support our community here. Wallahi, may Allah, I thank Allah.
ربيعي أنس أيامي صديقي بوح أحلامي شفاء الهم والشقوى يداوي جرحي دامي ربيعي أنس أيامي صديقي بوح أحلامي شفاء الهم والشقوى يداوي جرحي دامي ولما تهت ثم أتيت لدرب كلام رب البيت وجدت النور والسلوى مع القرآن اهتديت مع القرآن اهتديت
فيشرق صبح والحاني أرتله وأحفظه وأقرأه بمعاني أسير بدرب القرآن.